What's going on, beautiful people? It's the Kid J Nolan here, and I want to talk to y'all today about the fact that hip-hop and R&B finally has its own union, all right? So I want to give a huge shout-out and thank you to Chuck D, who's the founder of the Hip Hop Alliance. For those of y'all that don't know who Chuck D is, do your research, man. This dude is one of the founding fathers of conscious hip-hop, created the group Public Enemy with Professor Griffin, Flavor Flav back in the 80s. They did their thing well into the 90s. They still are out here putting out new music, going on tour and doing a lot. But over the years, a lot of hip hop artists and people that just came out during the early stages of hip hop and black music being a thing in mainstream, when their star power wore off, a lot of these people ended up going back to the same hoods that they grew up in and living lives that were not financially stable. You know what I mean? They were at the top of the world for 3, 4, or 5 years, and then they go right back to the circumstances that they started from, if not worse, because now you got to deal with the people in the streets knowing you for being this person. They expect you to have money and expect you to be at a certain level of success. So now when they see you, it's disappointment, which leads to depression and embarrassment and humiliation that often has run some of our pioneers into drug abuse and alcoholism and mental health issues. It's just been announced that the Hip Hop Alliance is now the union for hip hop and R&B artists so that we can put more emphasis on creating change in the community, all right? So that when artists retire, we can start having some type of pension plan in place. So I'm gonna get there, all right? So let me go in order of what needs to be said first. I'm on the Hip Hop Alliance right now, which is hiphopalliance.org, and I'm just gonna read through the website and give y'all the overview from the horse's mouth, okay? The Hip Hop Alliance is a 501c3 nonprofit organization whose mission is to promote fair wages, fair royalties, and strong health and retirement benefits for artists in the hip-hop and R&B community. The Hip Hop Alliance is one of the entities under the auspices of the United Coalition for Humanity, which is UCFH.org. The Hip Hop Alliance mission is to promote and secure the strongest protections for our members. We are rappers, singers, producers, songwriters, engineers, influencers, managers, DJs, musicians, radio hosts, comedians, podcasters, voiceover artists, dancers, and other media creators. Our goal is to extend pivotal union resources to all creators in hip hop and R&B. Inclusion. Whether it's education on music rights and law, health and pension benefits, or protection from unauthorized use of work, the Hip Hop Alliance strives to engage members so that they know and understand benefits that may be available to them. We are proud to be a model of inclusion, diversity, and democratic governance. The Hip Hop Alliance has partnered with SAG-AFTRA, the union representing many recording artists, on education and outreach initiatives. Improve. We're here to improve healthcare, educational tools, economic development, and employment opportunities for hip-hop and R&B artists. Partners, work within the framework of SAG-AFTRA to provide a voice and vehicle for greater hip-hop and R&B participation. Increase, union involvement in health and wellness, collective bargaining agreements, contract negotiation, and pension. Active, we're active in supporting human rights organizations working to improve living and working conditions in the hip-hop and R&B community. Alliances. Alliances between artists, concert venues, films, TV, media, streaming services, gaming platforms, community centers, nonprofit organizations, schools, churches, and other music and culture institutions. So let's get into the actual Hip Hop Alliance and SAG-AFTRA partnership. It's all about organizing this community using shared resources and strategies to achieve coverage, under the union's agreements with professional standards, compensation, and benefits. Engaging artists in the regular discussion of issues of concern in the artist's agreements with labels, producers, agents, and managers for the purpose of developing proposals to improve the union agreements covering these artists and or to promote positive change through legislation. Assisting this community of artists with the process of membership in the union, enrollment, and coverage in the health and pension funds, and working collaboratively to establish and support alternative resources for health and retirement benefits for those who do not yet qualify for union plan coverage. They're also here to establish a program of education to empower artists with information to support them in their personal negotiations with labels, agents, managers, and others to include career education, about contracts, payments, licensing, royalties, touring, representatives, dancers, team payments, setting up LLCs. If that sounds familiar to anybody, that's what I've been doing with the Pen Game portfolio. Music use and rights, i.e. music streaming, licenses to commercials, TV, film, streaming, copyright termination rights, new remixes, media, also something I've been doing with the Pen Game portfolio. For healthcare, retirement, and other areas of personal and family support. Not to mention financial planning for artists at their start through their retirement, something else that I've been developing with the Pen Game portfolio. So you got to understand, this stuff is like extremely important. And although this is a new union, a new program that Chuck D and others founded, it's something that's been needed for over 30 years. Okay. Not to mention it was something that was needed before hip hop was invented for our R&B artists and soul artists that paved the way for us as well. But it's been very pertinent as our music has taken over the world as the leading, most streamed, most listened to, most followed, and most duplicated style of music ever. And they've also got a piece here about legislation for artists, which is the American Music Fairness Act, which is a new bill to ensure that artists, performers, producers, and music creators are fairly compensated when their songs are played on terrestrial radio stations, which is another point that needs to be fixed. Because when you get your music played on terrestrial radio stations, as of now, there is no way to really make any money off of it. You can get paid public performance royalties and mechanical royalties off of when your music is played on internet radio. There is a streaming rate for that, but there is not currently money that comes back to artists when you get played on FM, AM radio stations. So it's pretty ridiculous. But hopefully this is something that will eventually reach some sort of agreement or understanding in the near future. For those of y'all that want to join the Hip Hop Alliance, they've got a form here where you put your first name, last name, stage name, put your email, your occupation, whatever position that you, you know, go by, whether you're a vocalist, producer, whatever it is that you do. They got plenty of options for you to choose from, and you can choose as many as apply. So you can put in multiple occupations or roles that you go by. Talk about the city and state that you're in, and you get to choose what you're most interested in, whether it's claiming unclaimed royalties, contracts and collective bargaining support, health plan support, pension plan support, retirement fund support. So this is all the pension plan and the retirement fund is really for artists to be able to retire and have money coming in after you're no longer putting out music, right? Health plan support is so that, you know, as a full-time artist, you are self-employed and you're not going to have the luxury of your job providing health insurance for you. So you got to go out there and get it yourself and pay for it yourself. But it can be expensive, especially when artists are already being cut out of the equation for a lot of payment in what we do. So as a lot of y'all already know, in 2021, I released the Pen Game Portfolio Volume 1 in January of last year. I dropped Volume 2 on Black Friday, and the reason why I felt like it was important to create the Pen Game portfolio was because there was such a big lack of music business information, and there were so many people out there that have already worked in the industry that were always very vague about how they got to where they were. They would always do these work hard, you know, giving people this motivation to just go back in the studio and create more songs, get cool with producers and all of this stuff, but they were not giving you the actual mechanics and behind the scenes information that you really needed in order to properly get your money when your music actually goes out. And this is why the Hip Hop Alliance is so important to me. You know what I mean? Me being an independent artist from Atlanta who's not been on Jay-Z level, I'm not on a P. Diddy level, I'm not somebody that could come in and create my own union, but I wanted to create something that could educate people at my level, those that are slightly above and those that are starting out, so that we can get ahead. I spent 10 years trying to get money off of music before I actually really got some, you feel me? So this is something that's really near and dear to my heart. So when I see Chuck D and Dougie Fresh and all of these people come out with the Hip Hop Alliance, and they've partnered with SAG-AFTRA, who, if you're familiar with SAG-AFTRA, that is a union that was created for primarily for actors, but entertainers, musicians are also included, especially if you're, you know, an orchestral vocalist or session musician or stuff like that. You can be a SAG-AFTRA affiliated union artist, but so many of us are not, you know what I mean? So this is kind of being able to bridge the gap so that we can join and have some sort of minimum requirement to say, yo, you're not booking me for free. And if you are, there's got to be certain requirements that are met if it is free. I have to see XYZ benefits. You can't just tell me exposure and thinking that's okay. But at the minimum, I should be paid X amount of dollars, whether that's $50, $100, whatever it's got to be. There should be a minimum, right? These showcases and things where you're actually charging artists to be a part of it, it actually makes absolutely no sense, especially if you're charging anything over $10, $15, maybe even $20. If you're charging $50, $100, $250 to get on a showcase, you are absolutely an artist. I'm not taking my words back. I'm not minting my words. You need to be bold out to paint, man. You know what I'm saying? Y'all been doing these oppressive things. Y'all not really giving anyone any benefit. By the time they leave your event, they're not familiar with nobody. The little bit of A&R people that you did invite, they really don't want to meet the artist. They judging. They a lot of times y'all be laughing at the artist while they performing, even when they decent. It's no respect there. And I don't care who sees this video and feels some type of way. There's no respect, not for me. Then you have these egregious contracts that so many artists are talking about. People have experienced, like I said, a lot of people get to the top of the mountain, their star power runs out, and they go back into poverty. It makes absolutely no sense that people that have created history, and I'm not just talking about music history, we're talking about American history, because world history, as a matter of fact, because this music reaches people on all the continents. It's not just about America. So make sure y'all visit hiphopalliance.org. Make sure you sign up on the form, get your information in there. They're supposed to get back to you within 7 to 10 days to let you know what the next steps are. There's definitely something that needs to be done about getting paid off of radio spins. We definitely need pension plans. We definitely need healthcare plans specifically for entertainers, musicians, etc. It's way too deep in the game for that not to be a thing. We just need more foundations. This is a professional career, man. There should be absolutely nothing that you do on this earth. If there's money in circulation, it should not be skipping over people just because you're not an executive running the situation. It makes absolutely no sense. Shout out to Chuck D, Slick Rick, Curtis Blow, all the Dougie Fresh, all the founding fathers that put in the time, the effort, the energy, because y'all don't have to do this. Y'all absolutely don't have to. And there's so many people that have proposed this idea that never followed through on it over the years. So I'm glad to see that there's really some progress going on, man. Y'all gotta salute the forefathers, man. A lot of y'all don't be wanting to respect the elders. This is a move that you're gonna have to respect. All right? Much love and respect, y'all. Peace.